Hello students, let us learn type 2 word problems. Those are age problems. The present age of Sahil's mother is 3 times the present age of Sahil. After 5 years, their ages will add to 66 years. Find their present ages. So in this word problem, we have to find the present age of Sahil as well as present age of mother. What we will do is, let us understand what is given in the problem. Let me read out this statement and we'll see what we understand by that. The present age of Sahil's mother is 3 times the present age of Sahil. Which means, let's say for example, if Sahil's age is 10 years, what will be mother's age? 3 times of Sahil's age, which will be 3 multiplied by 10, equal to 30 years, right? So here, to find Sahil's mother's age, it is important that we first find Sahil's age. So we will write the statement. Since his age is unknown, let us take Sahil's age as X years. So then what will be Sahil's mother's age? It will be 3 times Sahil's age, so it will become 3x. So let us first write the statement. So now we know that present age of Sahil is x years and present age of Sahil's mother is 3x years. Next, you see here it is given after 5 years. So let us write that here. Let's say your present age is 15 years. What will be your age after 5 years? It will be 20 years, isn't it? And how did we get that? 15 plus 5. Correct? Similarly, if present age of Sahil is X years, what will be his age after 5 years? We will have to add 5 to the present age, isn't it? So it will become X plus 5. Similarly, Sahil's mother's present age is 3x years. So after 5 years, it will be 3x plus 5. So let us write that statement now. After 5 years, so we now know their present ages and what will be their age after 5 years. Now read the other condition that is given in the problem. After 5 years, their ages will add to 66 years, which means after 5 years, when you add their ages, it should be equal to 66 years. So after 5 years, what are their ages? It is x plus 5 and 3x plus 5. So these two ages, when we add, the ages should equal to 66 years. So let us write that. Let us open the bracket. We will have x plus 5 plus 3x plus 5 equals 66. Now this is the linear equation that we have got here. Can you solve this linear equation and find the value of x? Yes, I'm sure you will be able to do it. You see here, we have x and 3x. Both these are like terms. So can we add them? Yes, we can. So 3x plus 1x will be 4x plus 5 plus 5 will be 10 equals 66. What will be our next step? We will have to transpose 10 to the other side. So 4x will be equal to 66 minus 10. So 4x will be equal to 66 minus 10 is 56. Let us now find the value of x. X will be equal to 56 divided by 4. So 4 ones are 4, ones are 4, carry 1. 4 fours are 16. So what is the value of x here? X is 14. What is x here? X is nothing but present age of Sahil. Therefore, present age of Sahil is 14 years. So what will be present age of Sahil's mother? 3 times of Sahil's age. So if Sahil's age is 14 years, 3 times of 14, that is 14 threesa will be 42. So we can say present age of Sahil's mother is 42 years. So let us write that statement now. It was 3x. So if you want, you can write there as 3x and then show the calculation, that is 3 multiplied by 14, which is equal to 42 years. Let us solve another word problem. Let us read out. Arjun is twice as old as Shreya. 5 years ago, his age was 3 times Shreya's age. Find their present ages. Now, this problem also is very much similar to our first problem. You read the problem again. Let us look at the first statement that is given to us. Arjun is twice as old as Shreya, which means, let's say if the present age of Shreya is 8 years, what will be Arjun's age? 2 times of Shreya's age. So 8 multiplied by 2, 16 years. That's how it should be, right? Since we don't know Shreya's age, we will take her age as x years. So then what will be Arjun's age? It is 2 times of Shreya's age. So this will become 2x. So let us write the statement. Let the present age of Shreya be x years and let the present age of Arjun be 2x years. Let us read the next statement that is given in the problem. 5 years ago. What do you understand by the word ago? They are talking about the past tense. In the earlier problem, if you remember, it was 5 years later. Later meaning we are talking about the future tense where we add the ages, right? Now here it is 5 years ago, which means we are talking about the past tense. Let's say your present age is 15 years. What was your age 5 years ago? It was 10, isn't it? That is 15 minus 5, which is equal to 10. Similarly, now present age of Shreya is x. So 5 years ago her age was, we will have to subtract 5 from the present age. So it will become x minus 5. Similarly, present age of Arjun is 2x. So 5 years ago, I will have to subtract 5 here. So let us write that statement now. So you see here, students, from just the first statement, we have got the first two statements here, that is the present age of Arjun and Shreya. And from this, 5 years ago, we have got their ages. That is, we have taken their present ages and we have subtracted 5 from them. Let us read the next condition that is given here. 5 years ago, his age was. Now, his meaning whose age they are talking about? Talking about the Arjun's age. So, 5 years ago, Arjun's age was meaning, I'll put equal to here, 3 times Shreya's age. That is 3 times, meaning you'll have to multiply 3 times Shreya's age. So 5 years ago, what was Arjun's age? It was 2x minus 5. So let us write that 2x minus 5 equals 3. We have got this 3 from this 3 times. So multiplication, if you want, you can show a bracket here, Shreya's age. So 5 years ago, Shreya's age was x minus 5. So you see, students, from this statement, we are getting a linear equation. So we will now solve this linear equation and get the value of x. So 2x minus 5 equals, let me open the bracket, 3 multiplied by x will be 3x and then 3 5s are 15. Let us bring the like terms together. We will have 2x here. Transpose 3x to the left hand side, it will become minus 3x. Right hand side we have minus 15. Transpose minus 5 to the right hand side, it will become plus 5. Plus into minus is minus. 3 minus 2 is 1x. Sine of greater number, that will be minus 1x. Minus into plus is minus. 15 minus 5 is 10. Sine of greater number, that is minus. Therefore, x will be equal to minus 10 upon minus 1. So, minus will get cancelled. What is the answer here? Answer is 10. So, x here is 10. And X is nothing but the present age of Shriya, isn't it? Shriya's present age is 10 years. So what is the present age of Arjun? It is 2 times Shriya's age. So 10 multiplied by 2 is 20 years. Let us now solve another age problem. Present age of Anu and Raj are in the ratio 4:5. 8 years from now, the ratio of their ages will be 5:6. Find their present ages. This problem is slight different from the earlier two problems. Earlier two problems, if you see, their ages were compared. But here, the ages are given in ratio. Now, a similar type word problem was done in type 1, where the ratio of the numbers were given. So, whenever ratios are given to us, we have to put a variable to it. That is, present age of Anu will now be 4x and present age of Raj will be 5x. So, let us write the first statement. Since the ratio of the ages were given of Anu and Raj, we have written the first two statements. What is given next? What is the next condition? The next condition that is given here is 8 years from now. So from this statement, what do you understand? Let's say if your present age is 10 years, what will be your age 8 years from now? It will be 10 plus 8, that is 18 years, isn't it? So when we say 8 years from now, we are talking about the future tense. That is, after 8 years, what will be their ages? So now, present age of Anu is 4x. So what will be Anu's age after 8 years? We will have to add 8 to the present age. That is 4x plus 8 years. Similarly, what will be Raj's age after 8 years? It will be 5x plus 8 years. That means we will add 8 to their present ages. So let us write the second condition and the statement. So we now have their present ages, that is 4x and 5x respectively, and also their ages after 8 years, that is 4x plus 8 years for Anu and 5x plus 8 years for Raj. So let us read the next statement that is given to us. 8 years from now, the ratio of their ages. What do you understand by the word ratio? Ratio meaning we have to divide their ages. After dividing, the ratio will be equal to 5:6, which means 5 upon 6. So let's divide their ages. That is 4x plus 8 divided by 5x plus 8. So when you take the ratio of their ages after 8 years, it will be equal to 5:6, which means 5 upon 6. So we have now got a linear equation, and you have solved this type of linear equations earlier, and I'm sure all of you know how to solve this, right? So can we find the value of x here? What will be our first step? We will have to cross multiply. So 6 will be transposed here. So 6 multiplied by 4x plus 8. Then we have 5 here. This term will be transposed this side. So it will be 5x plus 8. What will be our next step? Open the bracket. 6 4s are 24x. 6 8s are 48. 5 5s are 25x. 5 8s are 40. Further, let us bring the like terms together. So 24x transpose 25x to the left hand side, it will get subtracted. So then we have 40 here, transpose 48 to the other side, it will become minus 48. Plus into minus is minus, 25 minus 24 will be 1x. Sign of greater number, that is minus. Again plus into minus is minus, 48 minus 40 will be 8. Sign of greater number, minus. What will happen to the minus? It will get cancelled. So therefore, we can say value of x here is 8. Now that we have got the value of x, can we find the present age of Anu and Raj? Yes. Anu's present age is 4x years. So 4 multiplied by 8. Value of x is 8. So 4 8s are 32. So present age of Anu is 32 years. And what will be present age of Raj? 5 multiplied by 8. So 5 8s are 40. So present age of Raj is 40 years. Let us write that statement. So if you see here, present age of Anu was 4x. So 4 multiplied by value of x is 8. 4 8s are 32 years. And present age of Raj is 5x. So 5 multiplied by 8 will be 40 years. So I hope all of you have understood how to solve this type of age problems. Thank you, students.